In the following slides, we will talk about clinical protocol monitoring. Every day at 5 a.m., the Hospital Information System database talks to the clinical research database and updates the clinical research database with MRNs and demographics. And like the mother duck and its babies, the clinical research database is a big database with daughter databases. We have central disease registry and we have disease subtype databases for each individual subtype of diseases. And for each database, there is a team well trained on this on tasks to do with this database and responsible for maintaining this database. Let's focus on the central disease registry. Every day, the clinical research central database tells the clinical the central disease registry that the following MRNs are registered as new patients. The central disease registry team acknowledges that and start doing his tasks. Among his tasks is providing a provisional diagnosis and assign this provisional diagnosis to the MRNs. Unlike a dispatch, MRNs are automatically distributed to the individual disease subtype databases. Let's focus on this database, for example. This team here will verify the diagnosis, document the risk stratification, collect initial data, and start real-time follow-up. When the responsible team clicks this link here, a list of patients who are due monitoring appears, and the team responsible for follow-up will proceed according to the treatment roadmap. So let's assume that this MRN completed milestone 1 to 4 and is due monitoring for milestone number 5. The team checks the patient chart at the hospital information system against the roadmap, and if everything is okay, then fine. It will be documented that the milestone number 5 is completed as needed, and if not, for example, there is a protocol deviation or violation or any departure from protocol instructions, the team will investigate and report this violation or deviation. Finally, the disease subtype databases report back and again automatically to the central disease registry, report the patient status and survival duration. At the data center, there is a huge effort from building hardware and software infrastructure, integration between systems and computational software that enables us eventually to make real-time analytics. From this huge effort, we only see this link here, download analysis. When we click this link, the whole system moves together and produce real-time analytics like this. Thank you.